So we just pulled out this vintage looking military trunk. And before we even get inside of it, I want to show you a couple things that we noticed on it. One, look at this right here. If you can't see that on the camera, United States Air Force written right on the side of the box. But that's not it. If you come over here, oops, you can actually see where this was assigned back then, which is pretty cool. I've never seen anything like this in a unit in my life. And you can look up, apparently, I don't know if a person that owned this bought it or was trying to sell it, but it is a 1943 Foot Locker, which does make it World War II era. So that's pretty crazy. But the crazy part is that it's extremely heavy. You wanna see what we got?
Yeah.
This unit is like a museum. All right, let's be careful. I don't wanna let it fall.
All right, first, I wanna see what's
looking
on
there.
The basic Witz furniture industry, 1943.
1943, so it is definitely World War II.
And inspected by DK Wade.
All right. First thing we got. What is it? An old American flag. It looks old too, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. You see how the white's so faded like that? Definitely think it's an old flag. Let's fold it up, make sure it doesn't hit the ground. Put it right here.
These look newer.
Ooh, that does. What is it? A hat or a couple hats? Three hats? They're like really weird material. I've never felt anything like that in a baseball hat. Cap feel, hot weather. Not sure. They're military green, so I don't know if they're actually military or maybe the guy bought it because they just collected a lot of military and they would fit with the uniforms. I'm not sure. Check this bad boy out. Doesn't that look like something you see like a Wild Wild West cowboy pull up on you, pull out a revolver and go to work? What does it say? Text Shoemaker Company. And down here it says 416 on it. Don't really know what that means and everything. And over here you got Safeland? Is that what that says?
Safarland.
So that's pretty cool. I wonder if it's ever seen any action. What do you guys think? Looks pretty cool for sure. This, it looks like a tree, doesn't it? It looks like tree bark. Let's see what it is though. Ooh, really old paperwork. All right, let's see. Look at that. Top Tech's helmets ready to protect on duty. $23. I wonder what the date on this is. Oh, look.
1969.
It's the Journal of California Law Enforcement. 1969. Wow, that's old. What else do we have in here?
What the laws were back then.
probably better than they are now. Then again, that's not saying much. Am I right? Paperwork. What is that? Identification cards. Ooh, look at there's some old black and white pictures in here. Let's just get past the picture. What is that? Veterans Administration. I don't want to look at that stuff. Honorable discharge, it says, for somebody in 1953, so after World War II. So this might actually be like a World War II veteran unit. Let's get past that and get into the files. I think it's like Area 51 stuff they're gonna shoot us for finding.
I hope not.
I don't wanna show the name. Oh, this is a pilot, proficiency check. So somebody might have been actually in the Air Force. Huh. That's really, really cool, actually. But I mean, I don't know if it has value. What?
The instrument logbook.
Yeah.
That's where he tracked like how much he flew.
I think so. So that's kind of cool. What do we have here? Whoa. Got a tag hanging that says absolutely nothing. Great. But inside, oh whoa, look at this. Warner Brothers wardrobe. Is this used in like a movie? 16 times
25, 45? It's in the arm.
Where at?
Right here.
Can you see what that says? No.
Kleinerts.
I'm not sure.
That's all I can read.
But it's really heavy duty. I didn't know if they make clothes or not, so it might be a prop. Set that. Ooh, look at this hat. I'm cheating. I'm going under stuff. I want this now. Look at that. What era do you guys think this is from? Definitely probably military. I don't see why anyone else would need a freaking hard metal hat unless you're playing football or something, but definitely I would say military, but I don't know where, what era. doesn't look like the World War helmet you see. So maybe like Vietnam? Not sure.
I'm not good at history.
Alright, let's put that away. Oh. Oh. Look at this. Where do you think this was used at? I know like it's World War I when they really started implementing the trench warfare and stuff and using gas and all that. It says lot B243. But look on the strap there, you see that it says F24 and then 2 underneath of it. Whoa. I don't see any other markings anywhere. But that is insane. I saw something on the bottom actually. It says lot B256 and the number on it is E41R46. Does that mean it's made in 46? I don't know, it looks really old. Oh. Oh. Well, an empty gun sleeve, but it might be somewhere else in there, you never know. Oh, it's open. Well, I thought we had to say Fort Knox, but it's already open. No other markings on it. Looks like it was just like a piggy bank. Yeah. Car behind us is trying to leave and making the audio bad. I don't like them. Let's see. Ooh, look under there. Okay, no. You don't get to look. Not yet. So we have, this is definitely military of some sort. Anybody recognize the patches on the sleeve there? And look at this one. I've never seen anything like that before. You see anything else? Like a branch or anything like that? Oh, there it is. Look, U.S. Army uniform. But again, it doesn't tell us the year, so I don't really know how old it is. Where do we even start? Where do we start?
Ooh, a bunch of random things.
This, oh, yes, ammo can. It's heavy. What kind of ammo do you think it's full of? First, do you see a date on it? Oh, look. 250 cartridges, date
68.
68. So let's see what we have. Ooh. Ooh. They're all stranded together. Look at that. Oh. This is even like a big machine gun. Look at this. It goes like for a long time too. Jeez, look in the can. There's probably like 300 rounds in there. Okay, that's pretty crazy. I think it's like a big machine gun like you see in a, it goes on top of like a tank or something. It's just like, that's pretty sweet. Let's lock this back up. Where, I'll lock it up later. It's kind of annoying sometimes to get the ammo cans to shut.
Not really.
Yes, it is. Or else, what is that? It's like a designator. Oh, what if I hit
it? Detonator?
Yeah, you think if I press that at all?
Oh, I don't know, because it might blow something up in there.
Did I press it?
Do it.
Nope.
Aw.
Another one died. There's some numbers on the back of it, though. Can you see that? Yep. It's kind of beat up, though. What is that thing? It has a pencil in it.
No idea.
U.S. property. It doesn't say necessarily that it's military, but it's definitely something I've never seen before. Look at this helmet. Again, definitely Army. What's the tag say? $30, I guess, is what it's worth.
Yeah.
But again, we need you guys' help in the comments. What era do you think it's from? I don't think it's World War era. I don't think so. Looks like Vietnam. Then again, my military knowledge is based off of games and videos I've watched, so don't listen to me. Look at this one. 536 DGO. You think it's a license plate?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
To what?
I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know.
536 DGO.
Yeah, I mean, that could have just been the old license plates. That's just how they were.
Oh, no. Ooh, look at this. No, you gotta wait for that. Cover that. I don't get to see that. But look at these. American Rifleman and another American Rifleman, but they have little tags on them. Look at that, November 1955. That is really, really old. Really old. I think I have to save that for last. Look at this. What is that? Oh, San Francisco Police Department, maybe? We're like an hour and a half away from there. It's pretty cool. not as hard as the military, but still feels like a football helmet to me. Look at this one. Oh, no, no, we can't look at that one. Well, we can't look at this symbol right here because it's kind of, you know, YouTube doesn't like that symbol. But I'll just say it's German and it's probably World War II era, if you catch my drift. But is it a repro or is it a real one? Oh, look. That's some stuff inside of it, too. That's kind of crazy. I like the skull, though. I don't want to show that, but the skull looks kind of cool, doesn't it?
Yep.
All right. Oh, play with me.
Don't.
Say I won't. Say I won't.
You won't.
I won't. No, I'm scared. Look at that. Fuse M213, MEL 213. It's a grenade. Ooh. Can you, like, you think we could test it on the vehicles over there? Just go ahead, pull
the test it on those vehicles?
Test it on those guys? Should we just throw it at them? Should we just throw a grenade at them?
Yeah, just throw it at them.
Yeah. I don't think we want to blow it up. It might cause a chain reaction, blow the truck up, blow the car, which might blow our van up, and we can't have that, so let's not do that.
That's the only reason.
We got us a little canister here. Definitely military again. Definitely military again. Oh, look.
We're about to have a war here.
U.S. 1945. That's cool.
Ooh.
Whoa. What does this go to? 1942 AL lot 1392. It's a 40 millimeter MK1 round. That's gotta be like, is this in the screw? No, that's just the round. Imagine this. That's gotta be like anti-air vehicle. There's no way that's for a person. If it is, there'd be nothing left of them. That's gotta be the biggest piece of ammo I've ever seen. Look at that. It's the size of my forearm. That is a big boy right there. What is this thing? Not sure. You ever seen this?
No.
All right, somebody let us know what we have there. Is this? No, that looks like U.S. actually. That's kind of cool too. Definitely military again. This whole unit is like basically a military museum, guys. Let's see, before we get into that, what is this? I don't see nothing.
A piece of a hat?
It looks like a piece of an old hat, yeah. So I'm not sure about that either. All right, let's just pull it out. Oh, well, anytime you see the orange tip, you know it's not a good day. But it's like, it's a bolt action. Replicas by Paris. Look at that. Have you ever seen a bolt action toy gun? That's pretty cool. Bang. There's a New Testament U.S. Army and Navy edition. Another maybe license plate again. Oh, look at that. It almost looks German, doesn't it?
Yeah.
This is German license plates, and this is all World War II stuff. That's kind of insane. Almost knocked this big shell down. Let's put that back. And we got us two holsters that go together. Wow. I gotta say, it's probably one of the craziest trunks we've ever opened, guys. Ever.
All right, guys. I'm about to go through this box, and I wanted to get into something else, but hope you're having a wonderful day. So, let's get this thing. This
Gosh.
Caught my eye when I first looked into this unit. I love this thing. I don't know why, but it just looks really, really cool. So what I noticed first is that right here, it's like scratched inert. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. And on the bottom here, I don't think you're gonna be able to see it on camera, but no. 1945, it's also etched with M19 90mm, and it also has a long serial number on the bottom.
Looks like a tank round to me.
Whatever it is, it's bad butt, because I can't say, you know, the other one, so I'm gonna center myself, but it's really, really, really cool. So let's get into this box. So right off the bat, we have honorable discharge, paperwork, United States Air Force award. Right here, radiological defense volume 2, and it's from 1951. That's pretty cool. I got all old stuff in here. A Winchester repeating arms little plaque thing. This looks and feels newer. Yeah, 1991.
Still pretty cool.
Yeah, still cool, but just not like the vintage. So this is the recruit department, San Diego, California. Graduation platoon from 1985. There's all the men and women. I don't know if there's women on there.
80s? Should be, probably so.
Shouldn't be? Or should be?
I would think.
I don't know. I mean, I don't see any right off the bat, but I know they have to tie their hair up in that bun and put their hat on, so. Let's see, what do we have? Ranger Joe's International. This is just a magazine. I like finding the dates on this. 1994.
Good year, good year. The year I was born. Oh.
Next is, I didn't know that was there. the SS, the Third Reich.
Nine.
Hey, look, Alexandria, Virginia.
Really?
That's our hometown.
Hey.
Well, not this my book hometown, must suck. But. and the year in here looks newer, so 1988.
Not bad.
Still good condition from 1998. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
See what this is. This is a cool book right here. This looks like a photo album. Hold on, let me look in here real quick. Okay, so this looks like the only. Yeah, this is the only page that had something on it in here, but it has a subpoena and summons, extraordinary.
It's personal stuff.
What is Mount Vernon?
What? Oh, that's by us again.
Yeah, Mount Vernon, bound southward of the equator, blah, 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 blah. I don't know, a court, some kind of court summons, and on the back, I mean, it looks like just all the, maybe all the guys in the platoon that were on the ship dressing up in costumes and stuff. That's kind of weird. They like to have fun.
Can you blame them after what they've been through?
No. All right, here's another sign.
Aww.
U.S. property, no trespassing.
Put that on a gun safe at back in Virginia.
Yeah, that'd be cool to have, actually. This, whatever was in here was a plastic sign too. Carly Crescent, oh, okay. There's letters on the back of it.
Trenton.
Trenton, winter of 1776. Just a little story, maybe.
Yeah, no way, that's real, obviously.
Now here's two more. Let's see, we have
Bunker Hill.
Okay, so these were probably little boards that were put up in like a shop with maybe like on a wall and it had something beneath it or something like that.
Yeah.
So we have Montreal, 1775, and also Charleston, 1776.
What's significant about that year, guys? Show your American history in the comments.
These next books, the Army Field Manuals.
What, manuals for
weapons? Manuals on weapons, yeah.
Oh, that's a grenade launcher.
So this is 57 M18. Ours is to an M19. Do they have an M19 book?
Oh, the Browning. They have the instructor guide to the Browning machine gun.
There's an M18.
Guys, have you never seen a Browning in action? It's a huge machine gun that launches 50 cal shells, apparently. I didn't even know that.
Okay, so this has to be close to what, like, what this thing went to. This is an M18, but something like this. So it would get fed in this way.
So it's more of like an anti-tank instead of a tank.
Yeah. Let's see.
It's an M16.
I want to find a bigger picture of it.
I don't think they're going to have one.
Something like that. No, that's a telescope. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. That might be cool. One of those. It goes on the car like that. That's a machine gun, usually. Yeah.
Oh, no. Whatever it is, it's really, really cool. So, these little books are cool. Was there, 1955, 1952, 51, 55, 44 on the M1 and M1A1.
The M1.
1952. The only reason I've heard of those guns is from Call of Duty games.
Everyone laughs at video games. They actually teach you a good, like, for me at least, I played them before I learned about them in school. So then when I went to learn about them again, I'm like, wow, like these games are amazingly accurate. Like,
This right here is a field manual for how to read a map.
We need that. Well, it actually.
Well, I mean, we don't really need it. 1969.
Somebody's gonna say that in the comments. Well, what's gonna happen when the GPS is going? That's like saying like I own a horse in case the cars go down.
Yeah, this is a 1965. Military symbols, field manual.
Not bad.
1984 Aviation Week and Space Technology. So I think one of these guys that we keep finding in here was definitely an air defense pilot. In the trunk we found all the aviation stuff. So Soviet stream crossing equipment.
Hmm.
Okay. There's no date or any other information on this. Ooh, look at this old bag.
Oh, look at all the stuff below it.
The case navigation dead reckoning. Type A4. No date there. Let's see if we can get this off.
Don't break it. What's in there?
Nothing.
Just an empty bag.
Yeah, just an empty bag.
That's no fun.
But still cool. Alright, so we got some newspaper down here, San Francisco. What date? 1901.
Where do you see that?
Wait. This says 1965 up here, but yeah, it wouldn't be back then. This just says 1901, 16 pages, so.
Yeah.
1965. I think these were just like printed on there for the heck of it.
Something at the time.
Well, look, it says February 16, 1898.
Yeah,
so I think it's just made updated, but
I want to show the personal pictures.
All right, so we have some personal pictures here, some more military people. This is definitely male. It's up to date.
Oh no, I thought that was a sign.
No, just the magazine. Oh, this is like certain, I guess it's just illustrations. Oh, look at the horse illustration, actually.
Cool,
that's kind of cool. Horses and rides of the Old West. Ooh, a reward, $10,000 in gold coin. Will be paid by the U.S. government for the apprehension, dead or alive, Sam and Belle Starr.
That's pretty cool.
What else we got here? Ew. Are this teeth?
Ew.
That is not teeth. No, these are, it looks like oats. Why is there oats?
I just took something out because it's, again, you know, that World War II era German history stuff that YouTube's not too much of a fan of.
I covered it. All right, this next book.
I'm not a fan of this
pretty
either.
Cool. Oh. Hey, look, Rolling Stones photo album. Let's see what we got here. Is it like actual, maybe their own concert pictures?
It's like really bad condition.
Like their own clippings that they wanted to keep.
Yeah.
And this, the Union, 1861-1865.
Lincoln.
A book on, hey look,
there's
a little record in the back. All right.
There I was.
There it was. Little comic strips. These are more field books, I think. Department of the Army Technical Manual, 1976, 73, and I think these, ooh, look at the ship. USS Little Rock.
Not bad.
And this is the last thing, Department of the Army, Army Commendation Medal.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's it and that, but I mean, overall, I mean, just personal stuff, but I mean, really, really cool stuff. I'm like speechless on half this stuff because I don't know what it is, but it's cool.
Before we go out of this unit, we gotta show you two more crazy things. Look at this bad boy. Ooh, look at that rifle. Look at the length of it. To me, this looks like something like the British Redcoat Army and stuff would go, like when they used to just line up and just stand across from each other, like.
You know, your shirt's very, very fitting for this unit.
It is, right? I think so too. But that is bad. Look at the markings on the down here and stuff. Can you see it?
Yep.
That's really nice. You want to see something really cool?
Of course.
How about a freaking M16? But it's just a replica, guys. It's all replica. Look, it's all painted. It's just wood.
Nothing comes out.
It's wood. But it got me. See? All wood.
Dang it.
But it looks pretty cool, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Nice display piece.
Hope y'all liked this military stuff. I really love the military. I like to show support and appreciation because without them, we wouldn't have these freedoms to make these silly little YouTube videos that people love to watch so much. And if you want to see the rest of it, there's a full playlist, $5,500 storage unit on my channel, Storage Option Pirate. Feel free to go check it out.